Hold on that Torah. First nominee is. Y'all already, you gotta. All right, they got me covered. Man, he mad at all he corrupt. Yeah, no board. Okay. Hebrew Scholar of the Year. First nominee is Zion Lex. Second nominee is the Mighty Hebrew. Third is Divine Prospect. Who y'all say the winner is? And the winner is Divine Prospect. Come on, double time, soldier.
Thank you. Okay. Sure, this ain't too much. Oh man, I'm so honored. I want to say, first of all, thank you to Sonnetta for putting on this award ceremony. Thank you to everybody for the nominees and the nomination. I definitely appreciate that. Getting onto this platform, I'm telling you, man, it was not easy. My objective was unity, and I realized that that is a slippery slope at times, but that cannot deter you from the ultimate goal. The most important thing that we must keep in mind, if we are to be liberated, is through autonomy. We have to learn how to govern ourselves. Having an event like this, with us controlling it, us hosting it, us monitoring it, us protecting it, is a testament to what we can do as a people if we come together for unity. I want to give all praise now to the Most High God, to the people, to the ancestors that came before me, to the Nation of Islam in the house, my Kemetic brothers and sisters, to the Islam, Moors, PCL as well. And the last thing I want to say so that we understand, there's a war going out there, but the warfare starts with think tanks. Okay, let me say it again. There's a war going out there, and we've just seen the battles, but the real war is the think tanks. Me being called a scholar is something that I don't believe I deserve. But I appreciate the community for at least recognizing my work. But I realize at the end of the day, if we're going to win the war, we have to be the best think tanks. We have to put strategies out so that way we can overcome things 5, 10, 15 years from now. And the groundwork and the foundation is the scholarship that we leave behind as a legacy and a reminder to future generations that we will win the ultimate war. And with that, peace and shalom, family.
When you hear Israelites speak like that, then you know that it's the future bright.
You got that right.
Seriously, it's rare that you hear Israelites speak like that.
Yeah.
And that's a good thing.